beautiful Hector Arena in Pictou, Nova Scotia. My name is Michael Petter. This is Petter Sports and Streaming on AO Live. And this afternoon we have for you Maritime Major Female Hockey League action between the visiting Down East Auto Parts Stars representing Eastern Prince Edward Island and the hometown Northern Subway Selects, who represent the northern region of mainland Nova Scotia. Before we go any further, I must take a moment to acknowledge that the Pictou County Wellness Center, that's not where we are today, the Hector Arena, the entire town of Pictou, and the entire region covered by the Maritime Major Female Hockey League, which includes all of Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and Prince Edward Island, all lie within the ancestral and unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. And this game today between these two teams, it's the first of two games this weekend between these teams, and this promises to be an absolute barn burner of a pair of games this weekend. You've got the teams who sit first and third in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League standings. The Selects right now in the number one spot, holding the driver's seat in the league play as they have the top record, with a record right now sitting at 12 wins, 2 losses, and an overtime loss, good for 25 points, tops in the league. The Stars sit in third place with a record of 11 wins, 4 losses, and an overtime loss, good for 23 points, 2 points back of the Selects, 1 point back of the Greenfoot Capitals for the top spot in the league. When you look at these two teams, you're talking about superlatives across the board. You're talking about the teams who are, with the goaltenders, number one, and three of them are tied at number two in shutouts. The top goaltender in the league has 3 shutouts. That is one of the goalies for the Down East Auto Parts Stars, that being Hallie Blanchard. The other 3 goalies who are dressed today each have 2 shutouts, are all part of a tie for second place in shutouts. You've got the top 4 goaltenders for goals against average in the league, and for save percentage you have the goalies who sit at number 1, number 6, and number 7. And it's not just defensively that these two teams have superlatives. You have the top 3 players in the league in points, 5 of the top 8. The top 2 players in the league for assists, 4 of the top 5. The number 1 player for goals, 5 of the top 8. You have the players who sit first, second, and third in power play goals. You have 2 of the 3 players in this league who have scored twice while shorthanded. And out of the 13 shorthanded goals that have been scored in this season, all combined, 5 of the 13 shorthanded goals have been scored by these two teams. Superlatives across the board, like I said. And then you look at some of the team stats. The Stars, 3rd in the league in average goals scored per game at 4.19. Selects are first at 4.69. Selects, as you would expect, at the top for defense, 1.73 goals against per game as a team so far this season. That's first. The Stars tied for second at 2.0 goals against per game so far this year. Like I said, superlatives across the board between these two teams. However, if you were looking at the season series between these two teams so far, edge goes to the Down East Auto Parts Stars. They played twice in Eastern Prince Edward Island in late September. The Stars won the first game of that weekend set 5-2. They won the second game of that set 4-3 in overtime. So the Stars 2-0 against the Northern Subway Selects. And when we mentioned the Selects record, again, they only have 3 losses overall on the season. That one in overtime against these Stars, one of their 2 regulation losses against these Stars. So the Northern Subway Selects really with something to prove in this game here today and these 2 games here this weekend as they take on the only team that they have faced and not gotten a victory against as of yet. Before I go any further, I must take a moment as well to send a huge shout out to everyone watching back in Eastern Prince Edward Island. Last weekend, I was at the Monctonian calling games there, working with a couple of great announcers, Jeff Robichaud and Mike Sanderson. And I had the good fortune of calling a couple of games for the Charlottetown Knights, the U18 major team on the boys' side. Got to meet another number of the parents from that Eastern PEI team. And I know as I'm looking at this roster, there's a couple of surnames in common. So I'm guessing that if not brother and sister, perhaps cousins at least. So if you were one of the parents or fans from Eastern Prince Edward Island who got to watch the Charlottetown Knights games last weekend from the Monctonian, got to send you guys a shout out. And if you were there in the building last weekend and are watching from home this weekend, it was a pleasure meeting all of you, and I look forward to calling these couple of games for you here this weekend. It's one of the best parts of this job is getting to travel around, meet people from all over the Maritimes, and get to build those connections, build those friendships, and it really meant a lot to me last weekend meeting those parents from Charlottetown and getting to know how much they appreciated the work that I do. And I extend that now to the Down East Auto Parts Stars team. I have a little bit of a soft spot for the Stars as well. I was telling one of those parents last weekend about a time a couple of years ago when the Atlantic Championships were held in Membertou, hosted by the Cape Breton Lynx, and the Down East Auto Parts Stars were there representing Prince Edward Island at that championship. They came out during the intermission of one of the games, and there was a song playing, and they were dancing away on their bench, and I was up in my broadcast position. I started dancing away, and we had a little bit of a back and forth, a little bit of a dance-off, and it was a lot of fun, and I've always had a bit of a soft spot for the Stars, so this is going to be a great game, two fantastic hockey teams, and very much looking forward to what will be two exciting games of hockey here this weekend. As we get ready to get things started, we'll let you know that the starting goaltender for the Stars, it looks like it is actually both Stars goalies are heading to the bench, so we'll wait and see which one turns around. In the meantime, we'll tell you the starting goaltender for the Selects, who are the home team. They are in their home blues with the white and gray and yellow accents. It's Madeline Kerr getting the start. She's has a 5-2 record, a 192 save or goals against average. That's third best in the league, and 912 save percentage. And I now can confirm at the other end that it is Olivia Lowe, Kerr with two shutouts. Olivia Lowe, a 7-2 record, a 1.93 goals against average, a 921 save percentage, and we are underway here at the Hector Arena. And just to finish off the stats on Lowe, two shutouts as well so far this season. Puck is down into the Stars end. McDonald will play it up the wall. Picked up now by the captain, McDonald, as she gets it right back. In across the blue line, drops it off for Lawler. Lawler with a shot right in onto Kerr. Kerr makes the save and will hang on for a faceoff with just 26 seconds gone in the opening period. Just a quick note, we do like to try and be a little bit interactive with our broadcasts here at the Hector Arena. Anytime you're watching a game on Petter Sports and streaming through AO Live, we try to be as interactive as possible. There's three ways you can get a hold of us. Usually it's only two, but we've added a third one for today's game. And we'll get into those a little bit more in just a second. As the Selects get the puck up and in across the Star blue line, picking up there is MacArthur. Anna MacArthur with the shot and the save made by Lowe, and she'll hang on for a faceoff. So the three ways you can get a hold of us. First off, reach us through Facebook. Go to facebook.com. and search for Petter Sports and Streaming, where the and is an ampersand. And you'll notice that there's a post right at the top of the page about today's game. You can share a comment there in the on that page on Facebook. You can also reach us through X. Go to x.com, search for Petter, P-E-T-T-E-R, That's my last name, Michael Petter, P-E-T-T-E-R-P-C underscore sports. That's P-E-T-T-E-R-P-C underscore sports. And find me there on X. And the third way we'll talk about in just a moment as the puck comes out to center. Doyle goes to flip it back into the select zone, but it gets deflected up into the northern bench. And so we'll get a stoppage once again, and we'll tell you the third way to reach us. Go to mjahlnetwork.proboards.com. That's mjahlnetwork.proboards.com. Go to the section marked All Other Levels of Hockey and look for the post that says MMFHL Stream Eastern PEI versus Northern Nova Scotia with today's and tomorrow's date. And you can share your thoughts in that location as well. As the Stars end up icing the puck with 1:28 gone here in the first period, and we're off to a little bit of a slow start to this game. We've only played not quite a full minute and a half, and we've already had several, yes, I speak English, I do, really, several stoppages in play. And the faceoff down in the Star zone, draw one by the selects. It comes back to the line for Tanner. She'll play it down the boards, picked up there towards the corner by Reese Murray. Murray looking to get it to the front of the net. Maya McDonald trying to get a backhand shot away. She can't. It'll be picked up by Vint. Vint in the corner working there against Doyle. Doyle, one of those surnames that I used quite often in the Charlottetown Knights games a couple of weeks ago. Or not a couple of weeks ago, last weekend. So, and I realize that Doyle is quite a common surname. So not saying that they have to be related, but if they are. As puck comes out to center ice, picked up there and brought right back in again by Hallie Rose McLean. Hallie Rose leading the league in goals and point, or in goals rather, second in the league in points. Puck comes to the line, picked up there by Grinton. She plays it across to her defense partner, Boyle. Boyle plays it down around the boards. Matheson will pick up there for the Stars. Puck comes back to the line. Grint looks to work it back down low again. Hallie Rose McLean there working against Matheson. McLean, 19 goals on the season so far. Yes, you heard that right. In just 13 games, as she has not been available for every game that the selects have played so far this season. Hallie Rose McLean with 19 goals and 29 points in just 13 games played. An absolute phenomenal start to the season for her. Puck comes down into the select zone, but it's a offside against the Stars, so we'll get a stoppage with 3:12 gone here in the first period. Again, want to thank everybody for tuning in wherever you're joining us from here on AO Live, produced by Petter Sports and Streaming. Puck dumped down into the select zone, back to get. There is Lutley for the Stars. Played back to the line. Shot from the point by McDonald. That's blocked before getting all the way through. Now puck at center ice, picked up by Emerson McDonald. Several players with the surname McDonald. There's one for the Stars and two for the Selects, so we'll try and keep those players straight. And, of course, on both teams, number five happens to be McDonald, just to confuse me even more. Now with the puck, there's a pass ahead for Mullins from Lutley. Mullins had that go off her skate. Selects are able to pick up there and look to clear the zone. Puck is held in there. Great effort by Hunter. Now along the wall, Baker. Puck comes free to the middle of the ice. It's picked up and brought out by the Selects. Carrying through center is Vint. She has it knocked off her stick. Following up on the play was McIntyre. She dumps it in to the eastern zone. Now in the far corner, battle for the puck. It'll be picked up by Hunter. She'll play it to the line, held in at the point there as it was knocked down by Jean. Now it comes out to center. Jean plays it back in across the line. Selects were offside. That gives Hunter time to work her way out. She goes to dump it in. It goes off the stick of Murray and into the end boards. Should mention there is one lineup note for the Selects in this game, and I mention it while Murray and Emerson McDonald are on the ice, as it's the third member normally of their line, Kate Morrow, who is not in the lineup today. That the only scratch that I saw on either roster. And again, that's Kate Morrow, who normally plays on that line with Maya McDonald and Reese Murray. But it looks like they've got Rogan Vint as the third member of that line for today's game. Puck is played back in by Grinton after it was cleared out. And Lowe chooses to cover up and hang on for a faceoff with 5:30 gone here in the first period. Still looking for the first goal of this afternoon's game. Again, this is a two-game set between these two teams here this weekend. They'll play again tomorrow at 12 noon right here at Hector Arena. So two games between these two highly competitive, highly skilled hockey teams here from the Hector this weekend. Player not able to maintain control of the puck. It gets to the line, then gets dumped back in deep. Matheson gets to it there, plays it up the wall, held in again at the line. This time it's Ella Fitt. She'll work it back down deep again. Matheson again plays it up the wall. This time it was knocked down by Emerson McDonald. Now back to the line for Fitt. Her shot hits a couple of bodies on the way. Finally stops after it hits Matheson. And Lutley brings it out to center. Lutley gives to Mullins. Mullins coming in, gets a shot away. And that goes off the leg of McIntyre to the end boards. Comes back out right to Madeline Kerr. And Kerr covers up, hangs on for a faceoff. And we get a stoppage with 6:07 gone in the first period. And I see that my clock cam is acting up on me, so don't worry, folks. I will keep you up to date on the time during the first intermission, we'll see if we can figure out what's going on with our clock camera here. Right now it is Bria Tanner with the puck. She'll play it around to the near side. Up intended for Maya McDonald. She has trouble finding it in her feet as she's also being bothered there by Reardon. Now the selects try the far side. They do get the puck out to center. Maya McDonald plays it in across the blue line as Reardon was right there getting in her way. Now the puck played off the boards by McInnes. Comes back to Baker and played out. Or sorry, that wasn't Baker. My apologies. That was Larkin. 19, not 15. Now the selects back on it again. Here's McLean. Hallie Rose McLean goes to play it back, but a bit of a miscommunication there. And now a race to get to the puck. Boyle going against McPhee. McPhee able to get there first. McPhee plays it up the wall, stepping up from the point to get onto that puck as Hunter. Goes all the way back in behind the net. It'll be gathered up there by Jenna Beaton. She'll wrap it around the boards to the near side. And four or five players in the battle there. Now it comes back behind the net to Boyle. Carly Boyle with a little bit of time. She'll get it ahead to McLean. McLean tries to make a pass. That's knocked down by McPhee and played right back into the select zone. Now at the far side, Ailey Glenn. She'll play the puck out. Fitzpatrick sending it right back the other way again. And it will be gathered up by Grinton. She'll play it to the near side. Boyle will pick up. Boyle tries to feed it to McLean. McLean gets it, dumps it in, goes off of Hunter. And Lutley will come back and pick up right in front of the Subway Selects logo on the ice. Now Player has the puck chopped off her stick by Glenn. Fitzpatrick chops it up the near boards, but picking it up and carrying it forward now is MacArthur. Here comes Anna MacArthur with a shot. That goes off the shin pad of Hunter and into the near side corner. Lutley didn't like what she saw coming forward on the near board, so tried to turn around and go back, but ran right into Emerson McDonald. Now McIntyre plays the puck back down the boards. It comes back up again to McIntyre. She's able to chop it past Mullins. Picked up there by MacArthur. She plays it across the far side, and stepping forward is McHattie. McHattie has the puck stolen from her by the Stars. And now here comes Mullins working down the right wing side. Mullins trying to cut to the middle of the ice. Has the puck knocked loose. She was able to get a backhand shot away, but that gets blocked. And now in behind the net. Played around Alexi McIntyre by Emerson McDonald. McIntyre is going to reverse her field, come to the near side. And the selects bring the puck out to center. Emerson McDonald plays it off the boards in across the Stars' blue line. And the Eastern Stars in their old school Minnesota North Star green and white, or green and yellow with the white. work their way down into the select zone. Baker will send it back below the goal line for Reardon. Reardon looking to get it to the front of the net where Player was waiting, but not able to get a connection there. Now Lexi McIntyre, she'll pick up the puck, start to work her way out to center. Puck is knocked down there and sent back in across the line. Chopped ahead to Maya McDonald. Here comes McDonald coming in against Matheson. McDonald gets the shot away. That goes over the crossbar into the end glass, and the Stars quickly on the counterattack. Here's a pass across for Lawler. She'll have to pick the puck up off of the wall. Gets the shot away. It deflects, and Kerr had to react and was able to kick the pad out just as that puck was heading towards the near post. Now here comes Ailey Glenn on the counterattack going the other way. Ailey Glenn in across the line. Glenn gets it to the front of the net, but the only one there to get a stick on it was McDonald as the pass was out of the reach of Hallie Rose McLean. Now they battle along the near side wall. Puck comes back to the line. Grinton with it. She'll play it down the boards. It comes back up the boards and past Grinton and out as Lawler was able to get a piece of that. And all the way back down deep, Boyle picks up quickly ahead for McLean. Here comes McLean across the blue line. Takes the shot and the save made by Lowe, and she'll hang on for a faceoff as we've passed the midway point of this first period. 9:35 left to go in this first period. And let's just quickly see if what happens if I do this. Let's see what happens if I do this. There we go. Hey, there we go. There's the clock right where it belongs. Imagine that. A clock where it should be. Maya McDonald sends it down into the corner. Kaylee McDonald. If it should be Callie, I do apologize. Please do send me a message and let me know if I am getting any names incorrect. Only way I can fix a mistake is if I'm aware that it exists. Now here's Player with the puck. Player gets it to Lutley. Lutley's pass in behind Mullins. Mullins has to turn back. She's able to get the puck and dump it in. Fitt picks up as it was rattling its way around the boards. Fitt sends it out to center, gathered up there by Larkin. She sends it back down into the select zone. First one on it there is Mullins. Mullins taking it behind the net. Mullins tries the wraparound. Save made. Puck loose at the side of the net. Now behind the net. Fitzpatrick will engage from her spot at the point. Tries to play it towards the front of the net, but it ends up right on the stick of the selects Emerson McDonald, who's able to get almost all the way to the blue line before she dumps the puck in and peels back for a change. Reardon. Pass intended for McPhee. That's broken up by Murray. Now brought in across the line by Vint. Vint takes it down into the corner. Vint plays it off the wall. Maya McDonald there. Now she's taken off the puck by Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick plays it around to Reardon. Reardon cannot clear the zone as Beaton knocks that puck down before it can exit. And now the puck is cleared down the ice and Tanner hustling back to it. It's going to be an icing call against the Stars. 7:56 left to go here in the first period. And while we've got a break, we'll let you know that there are a couple of other games going on in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League today. Three others in total, two of them not yet started. The one game that is underway is the other Prince Edward Island team, the Western Wolves, out of the western half of the province, at home against the Fundy Kraken, and the Wolves off to a good start there. 2-0 in that one, and that game is in progress in the second period. We'll keep you up to date on that. The other two games that start a little bit later, the Greenfoot Capitals at the Lindsay Surge, that game being played in Dartmouth, and in Moncton at the J.K. Irving Center, it's the Western Flames of Western New Brunswick taking on the Moncton AAA Rockets. Here we're still looking for the first goal of the game, Stars and Selects. 7:18 and counting left to go in the first period. Puck takes an odd bounce off the corner. Now at the side of the net, Kerr able to find it, and she covers it up, and part of the crowd goes tumbling down as we get a stoppage. 7:11 left to go in the first period. And if I were in Western Canada, I'd make some sort of a comment about going for a Slurpee right now. But since I'm not, I won't. Oh, wait a minute. I just did anyway. And if whoever the parent company of 7-Eleven is, if you want to fire me off a check, I won't mind. As the lines person letting it be known that both wingers who are on the far side there getting a little too close before the puck was dropped, so we had to wait. Then we did it and got things going. Here's Hallie Rose McLean working her way down the left wing side. McLean takes the puck behind the net out into the right wing corner. Has that puck get a little bit too far away from her. It comes towards the line. Beaton not able to hold it in. And the Stars come out. Here's a pass across to the near side for Lawler. Lawler, she'll use the wall to send the puck around to the far side. Picked up by Boyle. Boyle gets it ahead, and here comes McLean. McLean having a little trouble getting the puck to sit for her. Once she does, she dumps it in and heads off for a change as the Selects change up their forward unit. The puck rolls in towards Kerr, and Kerr covering up as a few Stars were getting into the neighborhood. So with 6:32 left to go in the first period and no score, we get another stoppage in play down in the Northern Subway Select zone. Once again, oh, I see I got a notification on Facebook. Let's see here. Got a message from John and Nancy Steves watching their granddaughter Emily Lutley and the team watching from down in the Annapolis Valley. Well, John and Nancy, thank you so much for tuning in. And really do appreciate having you here for the ride. Puck comes back to the line. Fit with a shot. That gets through. Save made by Lowe. And the puck ends up at the near wall. Mullins will pick up. She'll bring it out. Mullins pass intended for a player a little too far in front of her. Fit will go and get it in the corner. Plays it up the wall there for McHattie. McHattie gets it to the line. Looked like Fitzpatrick was going to hold it in, but then Mullins got on it. Mullins had it knocked off her stick by Fit. And down into the Stars zone. Hunter. She'll cycle it back the other way to Fitzpatrick. Played ahead now. Sorry, that wasn't Fitzpatrick. That was Reardon. There's a shot in right onto Kerr. And Kerr covers up and hangs on. 5:32 left to go here in period number one. And again, we really do appreciate having everybody along for the ride, wherever you're joining us from. If I didn't have you guys watching at home, I wouldn't have a job to do. So it really is my pleasure, and I really am so grateful for all of you who are watching. Here come the Selects. Having a little trouble getting out of their zone. Vint has to come back and pick up the puck. She'll play it off the wall. It hops just over the stick of Doyle. Doyle back to get it. She'll play it up the wall. Vint there to get a piece of it, but couldn't maintain control. Now it comes to the near side. McInnes will get to it first for the Stars. Plays it as far as the Select blue line. Maya McDonald, plays it back. Now gets the return pass. That pass for Maya McDonald. She wasn't quite able to keep it settled, and now Matheson overskates the puck as both teams having a little bit of trouble getting the puck to do what they want here in this first period. Puck goes down below the goal line, gathered up there by Rianne Jean. Comes out to the front, but we're going to have a penalty as Jean was taken down, and so our first penalty of the game will go against the Eastern Stars, the Down East Auto Parts Stars, and it's going to go against Lawler for tripping with 4:42 left to go in the first period. And so the Northern Subway Selects will go to the power play, and the Selects power play, unfortunately, we're not able to get exact power play percentage stats, but we can tell you that the Selects have been very good on the power play so far this season with 15 power play goals in 15 games. So that's pretty easy math to do. They've gotten one power play goal on average per game. Hallie Rose McLean with 7 of those power play goals so far this season. So almost half of them. And this is her with the puck right now coming in across the blue line, taking it down to the hash marks along the near wall. Tries to get the puck to the front of the net, but that gets taken away by Kaylee McDonald. And now it's played ahead. Here comes McPhee. McPhee with a shot. And the save made by Kerr, and she'll hang on for a faceoff. 1:19 left to go in the penalty. And 4:01 left in the period. We can also tell you, like I said, we don't have access to stats as far as the power play and penalty kill percentages, but we can tell you that Avery McPhee, who just took that shot, with 2 shorthanded goals so far this season, has the only 2 shorthanded goals that the Down East Auto Parts Stars have scored so far this year. Selects hemmed in their own zone again, as the Stars, with a very aggressive penalty kill, taking a page right out of the Selects playbook. That shot gets blocked, and now here come the Stars back the other way as MacArthur carries the puck up. MacArthur drops it off for Emerson McDonald. Her shot is blocked. Now it's McIntyre. That shot blocked as well. It ends up going down towards the end boards. Picked up. Brought back to the line for Jean. Jean plays it down into the corner for Emerson McDonald. It's stolen from her by Hunter. And Hunter will wrap the puck around the boards. Down the ice it goes. 26 seconds left to go in the penalty. McIntyre out from behind the net. Her pass for Hallie Rose McLean hops just past her stick and down the ice. We'll get an icing call against the Selects. 17 seconds left to go in the penalty. 2:59 remaining in what is so far a scoreless first period. Plenty of action, plenty of back and forth speed, but no scoring as of yet on either side. Face off deep inside the Northern Select zone. Pass ahead. Here comes Ailey Glenn. It's hopped off, knocked off her stick. Baker took looking to come the other way, but getting her stick in the way there was Jenna Beaton, and the puck ends up in the Stars bench, and we get another stoppage with 8 seconds left in the penalty and 2:50 remaining here in period number one. Faceoff will be just outside the Northern Subway Select zone. The captain, Jenna Beaton, taking the draw against Baker. Comes back to Grinton. She gets it ahead for McLean. Hallie Rose McLean will dump it in deep. Going in against Doyle. Doyle able to poke the puck up the near walls. Grinton engages from the point. Got on the puck momentarily. Then Emerson McDonald. Her pass intercepted by McInnes, who's coming up the other way. McInnes with the shot. Kerr the save. And Kerr will hang on for another faceoff. 2:27 left to go in the penalty. And still no score. 2:27 left to go in the period. My apologies. Penalty expired. And the faceoff inside the Northern Subway Select zone. And as we mentioned, the Selects with a pair of losses against this Stars team already this season. They've played twice. They've got these two meetings this weekend here in Pictou. And then they won't see each other again until possibly at the Atlantics, which will be hosted by these Northern Subway Selects. So we know the Selects will be at the Atlantics. And for the Eastern or the Down East Auto Parts Stars, they know that they have to win a series against the Western Wolves once we get to the end of the regular season. We'll talk more about all of this in the second period, but the Stars have one team in their way to get to the Atlantics. The Selects will get in by way of the host berth, but a couple of the Select players that I haven't heard this from them firsthand, but talking to the head coach, Craig Clark, he's told me that there's a few Select players who have said, basically, if we don't get in through the front door, I don't want to play in it anyway. So the Selects, they have the Nova Scotia banner in front of them as a primary goal for this season. They want to earn that berth, not just be able to say that we're in the Atlantics because it happens to be in our building. Stars with the puck. Lutley tries to turn it back up. That gets knocked down in the corner there by one of the Select players. Couldn't quite catch the number. See now that it was MacArthur. Now player with the puck for Eastern Stars. A return pass from Mullins, a little bit behind the intended target. Larkin holds the puck in at the line. And now taking it back, trying to turn McIntyre as we're into the final minute of the first period. McIntyre not able to clear the zone as player hard on the forecheck. Now played around to the far side. Fit trying to find an exit lane. Can't find one as player creates the turnover. Player's pass, however, just off target. And that will allow MacArthur to get the puck out to center. Here's MacArthur. MacArthur. Her pass for McIntyre just a little bit behind her as Lexi McIntyre had a little more speed than I think Anna MacArthur was expecting. Now it comes around the board. Fit holds it in at the line. Fit will send it back down deep. Picking up from behind her net is Baker, and Baker will move her way forward. Here comes Baker coming through center. Baker with a shot. That goes high into the glass. 13 seconds left in the period. Baker sends it back down low. It's along the near side boards. They battle for it. Puck comes back to Baker. Her shot gets blocked. And there's a backhander by McDonald. That doesn't get through. And that will bring us to the end of period number one. Shots on goal favor the Stars 7-6. And the score at the end of 20 minutes of play, both goalies stopping everything they've seen, which means it's Stars 0, Select 0 in a very quick first period of play. We're going to take a break. We'll come back, get you ready for the second in just a few minutes. You are watching Maritime Major Female Hockey League action from AO Live, produced by Petter Sports and Streaming. Stars 0, Select 0. We'll be right back in just a few minutes. Welcome back as we get ready for the second period here between the Selects and the Stars. Couple of updates on a couple of things that we mentioned in the first period. First off, an update on Kate Morrow. Morrow is out with an undisclosed injury. I talked to Craig Clark. He mentioned that she is here at the game today, but is out of the lineup for this weekend. And when I asked him, he says week to week is the status on Kate Morrow. And I didn't catch the name of the person who sent me the information, and I'm having trouble finding it now. Here, let's see if I can find it again. But got confirmation that Jessie Doyle is indeed the older sister of Tyler Doyle, who plays for the Charlottetown Knights. So second straight weekend calling a game for players in that family. Calling a couple of games for players in that family. So you never want to presume that it's a connection, but nice to know when it does get confirmed for you. And one last update. Due to some other concerns, my camera person had to leave after the first period, so I'm going to be flying solo for the rest of this game, working camera and doing play-by-play. So if the camera quality starts to suffer, that's why. It's nothing serious. Let me be 100% clear on that. It's just a minor issue that my camera person, Melody, my daughter, had to take off. So I'm going to be flying solo for the rest of today's game. And we'll do the best we can with what we got here. All right. Second period underway. Hunter at her own line. Pushed the puck forward. It was picked up by McIntyre of the Selects. She gets it deep into the Star zone. Fitzpatrick playing it up the far wall. Mullins not able to get past MacArthur as the puck comes around to the near side. And we'll mention again, as we do during every broadcast here at the Hector Arena, when the play is along the near side corners, we know that the camera can't get in there quite as good as we would hope. But we again have to send out a huge shout out to Ronnie Clark, who did a great job of setting up this broadcast position for us. There's a couple of good chances in close for McHattie. And Ashton McHattie not quite able to solve the puzzle that is Olivia Lowe. One other update from the end of the first period. The shots on goal got changed to 8-7 in favor of the Eastern Stars instead of 7-6 for the Stars, which tells you how good of a job Billy and the rest of our crew down in the penalty box are doing on tracking the shots on goal, as they were only off by one for each team. Yes, there's our unofficial shot count, which goes up during the period as play goes on. And then the official shot count keeper, who sits up in the stands and watches the game from up there, comes in and lets us know how many shots need to be changed. And sometimes it's a change of one or two. Sometimes it's a change of none at all. As our guys down in the box, they do a great job down there. It's not always easy from right at ice level, just off of center ice, to tell what's a shot and what's not, but they do a great job of it game in and game out. Here's Reardon with the puck for the Stars, plays it off the wall, gets it as far as McInnes. McInnes will send it down the ice. Icing gets waved off. Back to pick up is Tanner. Tanner looking to quickly play it back up ice. Her pass for Vint, though, gets intercepted by McPhee, but McPhee ended up overskating the puck. Now Lawler picks it up in neutral ice and gets it down into the Select zone. Hustling to get onto it there. I believe that was not Baker. That was McPhee, sorry. Now working to get the puck out to center ice was Hallie Rose McLean. Couldn't maintain control, however. Now coming back in, there's a shot taken by Lawler, and the save made by goaltender Madeline Kerr, and she'll hang on for a faceoff with 3:12 gone in this second period. So I'm not going to be as close watching the social media here in this second period as we were in the first, just because I have to work the camera myself. So I'll apologize in advance. If anybody sends me a message, I will get to it in the intermissions. We'll try to, if we get a bit of a stoppage where maybe I can take a quick peek, we'll try to do that. As we get an icing call against the Selects, and on an icing, there's a little bit more time, so we can do a quick check here. Doesn't appear that there's anything else, and of course, yeah, all right. So face-off inside the Select zone. Lutley gets waved out of the face-off circle. Mullins will come in to take the draw. And there we go. Mullins pushes the puck forward off of the face-off. That gives the Selects possession, and here comes Ailey Glenn. Glenn working down the right-wing side, heading towards the net, gets it to the front. Hallie Rose McLean gets a stick on it. They score! Not sure if it was McLean or leading the way across the front of the bench is Grinton. So it might be Ella Grinton getting the goal, and if so, it's her second goal and fifth point of the year. Time of the goal, 3 minutes 48 seconds. We'll get you confirmation of whether it is indeed Ella Grinton who gets the goal here in just a moment. Like I said, Grinton's the one who led the celebration across the bench. So they announced the goal as Grinton unassisted at 3:48. For Grinton, that is her third or second goal and fifth point of the season. That puts the Northern Subway Selects out in front 1-0 here in this battle of two of the top three teams in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League. The team that's right up there with them in many of the categories, the Greenfoot Capitals, not in action, or they are in action today. Just their game hadn't gotten underway yet. They're taking on the Lindsay Surge in a game that should be just a little bit underway now. We'll see if we can add a stoppage in play, possibly get you an update on how that game and the other games in the league are going. In the meantime, here comes Beaton with the puck. She puts it right on, and we'll get a stoppage as it's smothered by Olivia Lowe, and she'll hang on for a faceoff with 5:11 gone in the second period. Let's see here. As we try to do several things at once. Yeah, no update on the game between the Greenfoot Capitals and the Lindsay Surge as of yet. The Western Wolves now lead the Fundy Kraken 3-0. That game should be into the third period, I do believe. There's a shot that goes high. And then a game starting at 6:30 this evening, so it likely won't start until our game is just wrapping up. And that is the Western Flames of Western New Brunswick taking on the Moncton Rockets. And the one team not in action this weekend in Maritime Major Female Hockey League play, the Cape Breton Lynx. There's a shot. Kick save made by Kerr. Hallie Rose McLean plays the puck to Beaton. Goes into the Select zone, or the Star zone, excuse me. Matheson turns it up the other way. Now bringing it in across the line, that was Lutley. Played around to the near side, going after it there is Player. Player gets tied up with Lexi McIntyre. Puck goes behind the net, and Grinton, the goal scorer, is able to pick it up there as the Selects start to work their way out. Here's Emerson McDonald, fanning on a shot attempt. Lutley comes back, picks up the puck. She's being chased by MacArthur. Or sorry, that was McHattie. McHattie 14, not MacArthur 16. Now, here's McIntyre. McIntyre's shot goes off the leg of McDonald. Going after it in the far corner was MacArthur, now McHattie. As we got Mac, and Mac out there on the ice right now. Not quite that many Macs, but it feels that way sometimes. And now coming the other way, here comes Baker. Baker working up the left side of the ice. Baker trying to get to the middle, gets the shot away. And the save made by Kerr, and she'll hang on with exactly 7 minutes gone here in this second period of play. Selects with the 1-0 lead off the goal by Ella Grinton, her second of the season. I thought there might have been an assist on that goal, but it ends up going as an unassisted marker. McPhee will take this faceoff for the Stars against the captain of the Selects, Jenna Beaton. And Beaton wins the draw towards the wall. But then McPhee wins the race to get to the puck. Pass to Gardner. Gardner with a shot. That goes wide. Puck comes all the way up the boards to Fitzpatrick. She plays it back down. Gardner can't quite get a stick on it there. And Beaton will get it to the line and out. Picked up by Hunter. Hunter going cross ice. Is able to connect that pass with Lawler. Lawler with a shot. It goes wide. Puck will come up the boards. Hunter engaging from the point. Gets down to the hash marks. Is able to get onto the puck there. Lawler was on it for a moment, but now it's picked up and taken out to center by McLean. Hallie Rose McLean. Tried to go through three Stars. That doesn't work. And now Gardner coming the other way. Gardner takes it down into the corner. In behind the net. Plays it towards the front of the net. And Madeline Kerr is there to cover it up and hang on for a faceoff. 7:51 gone here in period number two. Quick check again. Oh, let's see. What do we got there? Oh, that's not a real notification. That's a spam, so we can ignore that one. And as we go to delete the spam, we end up letting go of the camera and it falls down. A long lead pass just out of the reach of McHattie. As down the ice it goes, and that's going to lead to an icing call against the Selects, with just over 8 minutes gone now here in the second. And let's see, what does this say? Not Tyler Doyle, Ryan Doyle. Sorry, Beverly. Trying to go from Tyler Doyle is a player who played for the Pictou County Weeks Junior A Crushers for several years. So when I see the last name Doyle, for some reason my brain just went there first. I apologize. I didn't mean any disrespect by that. Sorry, Ryan Doyle, the younger brother of Jesse Doyle here on the Stars. Thank you. And it's Beverly Kelly who sent me that information. So thank you very much again, Beverly, for that. All right, here come the Selects coming in. McHattie at the front of the net, and what a save there by Lowe. Perfect pass right into McHattie. McHattie with the redirection, but Olivia Lowe making the stop. And a perfect save there on that one for the Down East Auto Parts Stars. What a save. All right. Now, Maya McDonald tried to turn and dump the puck back in, was not able to do so. In below the goal line, puck comes back to the top for Baker. There's a shot that goes just a little bit wide. Selects look to come back out. Maya McDonald drops it off there for Reese Murray. Murray dumps it in, comes off the end boards, back to pick up is Larkin. Larkin now plays it ahead to McInnes. McInnes tries to go cross ice with that pass. It gets deflected, and so Reardon not able to pick up. Ailey Glenn gets it for the Selects, and Glenn in across the blue line, fires a shot, and a blocker save made by Lowe. Lawler able to get the puck out to center. Cross ice pass intended for Glenn gets deflected. Now Kaylee McDonald will bring it in, but not sure if it was Gardner or McPhee, but one of them in just a step early, and we'll get a stoppage. With 10:29 remaining here in the second period, Selects with the 1-0 lead on the second goal of the season for Ella Grinton. the lone goal by either side out of the 24 shots that have been taken on Olivia Lowe and Madeline Kerr. Kerr has faced 11. Lowe has faced 13. There, Kerr has faced 12. Now Kerr has faced 13 as a couple of shots get in there, and she makes the save on both of them and then covers up and hangs on for a faceoff. Again, these teams will meet tomorrow at 12 noon. So we'll have more Maritime Major Female Hockey League action. Come right back to AO Live, this exact same site. You'll see the link for that particular game, and you'll be able to tune in and catch all the action. So as the old TV show from the late 60s used to say, same bat channel, but obviously it won't be the same bat time as the game starts at noon tomorrow. Battle right in front of the penalty box, directly in front of our broadcast position here at the Hector Arena. Now, Beaton able to dump the puck down into the star zone. Back to get it there was Fitzpatrick. She plays it around to the far side. Mullins, her pass just a little bit behind player. Player able to pick it up off the wall. Goes to get it back across to Mullins, but that pass was broken up by MacArthur. Now McIntyre with it. McIntyre circles to get away from player. McIntyre still with the puck. Now she'll play it ahead. In across the blue line, stepping up. MacArthur with a shot. The save made. And Lowe with incredible rebound control. That puck meant maybe an inch and a half off of her pad. So it was right there for her to cover up. You want to teach a goaltender how to control rebounds, show them that save right there. That was about as good as you can do it as a goalie. Making that save and allowing absolutely zero rebound. Olivia Lowe with a great play there. Now here down in the select zone, McInnes in there pressuring. As they continue to battle for it, 3-4 players in there. It comes free finally to Reese Murray. Murray takes it behind her own net, plays it ahead, intended to get it to Maya McDonald, but Baker stepped in the way of that pass. Now it's played out to center. Kaylee McDonald will pick up, bring it right back in again. The Stars captain with a shot, and the save made, and it goes over the glass and out of play. We'll get another stoppage with 8:23 left to go in this second period. Selects out in front, 1-0. Shots on goal. Again, these are the unofficial shots on goal at 14 apiece. Okay, let's see here. We got our clock cam acting up on us again. Let's see if we can find the right spot. There. And while we're trying to fix that, we lose this. Try to adjust two cameras at once, and neither of them end up looking right. Sorry about that, folks. Just under 8 minutes left to go here in the second period. 1-0 for the Stars, or for the Selects, excuse me. The goal coming earlier on this period. Here comes Gardner. She has the puck knocked off her stick. And now McHattie sending it up the other way. Puck dumped in right onto Lowe. Lowe sets it aside there for Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick able to get it out to center. Gardner dumps it back down into the Select zone. Northern Selects look to clear the zone. Player got a stick on that pass, but it still just got through. There's a shot that goes wide of the net into the end boards. Working along the near side wall. Again, this building, this is the 51st season for the Hector Arena, and so obviously when it was built, sight lines for internet streaming, obviously not even so much as a thought when this arena was built. But again, we got to give a huge shout out to Ronnie Clark and the rest of his crew who put in this plexiglass. If you look all around the rest of the rink, there's netting all the way around the rink, but Ronnie Clark and his crew put in a little bit of plexiglass specifically so that when we are here doing Northern Subway Selects games, we're able to get you a good picture. And we have to give Ronnie and his crew a huge shout out for doing that for us. As the puck cleared down the ice, back to get it is Tanner. Tanner has a player on her right away, and coming back to help out, Reese Murray plays it around to the far side for Jean. Jean able to get it ahead to Maya McDonald. Her pass a little bit behind her intended target of Vint. Now it's back onto the stick of Jean. As Maya McDonald went to dump the puck in, and it ends up getting touched by a glove on the Eastern Star bench, and so we'll get a stoppage. With 6:11 left to go here in the second period. And again, I know the clock cam keeps moving on us. I've got a bit of a loose pin that I cannot tighten on that tripod. Maybe during the second intermission, what we'll do is we'll change tripods if we can. Try and get that to happen for you here in the second intermission, which is still 5 minutes and 57 seconds of playing time away. So just bear with us on that clock cam until then if you can. Lawler with the puck. She's able to get it up to Gardner. Gardner split, trying to split through the defense. Gardner still with it. And a great hustle on the back check there by Beaton and Glenn. A couple of forwards both involved in that back check as they denied Emily Gardner of getting a shot away. Now Glenn does get a shot. That gets blocked by Larkin. Stars back on it as they look to come back out. Mullins with a nice move there at her own blue line. Another move as she cuts to the outside. Now Mullins ends up losing the puck as McHattie was able to slow her up enough. Fitt got the puck ahead, but that was knocked down by Hunter. Now Fitt back on it, trying to get away from the pressure of Player. And coming in to help out for the Stars is Lutley. She'll play it back to Hunter. Hunter with a shot. It gets through. Save made by Kerr. Now below the goal line, Player takes a bump from McIntyre, and we're going to get a penalty, and it's going to be McIntyre for body checking, just the second penalty of this game. First one taken by the Selects. 4:54 left to go in the period, and let's see if I can pull this up really quickly. Like I said earlier, we're not able to get you percentages, and I don't think I'm going to be able to pull it up in time to get you exact stats on how many power play goals the Stars have scored this season. Unfortunately, just not quite enough hands once my camera person had to step away. So I can't get to the computer and use one hand to hit the computer. Maybe I can here. Here, let's try and do this real quick while the play is down at the far end. Let's see here. Stars come through center. All right. While all that happened, I was able to hit enough buttons on my computer to pull up the fact that the Stars have scored 20 power play goals so far this season in 17 games. Actually, this is the 17th game. Is it not? I thought, oh no, yeah, because they played 16. This is the 17th. So 20 power play goals through their first 16 games this season out of the 32 regular season games. So they've hit dead on their midpoint of the season. Selects are hitting the midpoint of their season today with game number 16. And the Selects have 3 shorthanded goals so far this year as a team. 2 of them by one player. And I believe that's Hallie Rose McLean who has the 2. Leading power play goals for the Stars, it is Callie McDonald with 9. Ellie Mullins has 6. There's a shot taken by Reardon. That goes off a leg and into the inboards. Reardon back on the puck. Tries a wraparound and scores! Cameron Reardon, with 9 seconds left in the penalty, ties up this game at a goal apiece. 3:03 remaining in the second period, and we're all tied up. Cameron Reardon, with her second goal, fourth point of the season, ties up the game on the power play. It is 1-1. I believe player gets an assist, but I'm really not sure. So we'll have to just wait for the official word on that. Puck comes all the way around the boards to the line. McIntyre holds it in. So Reardon gets that goal unassisted as well. So both of our goals in this game coming unassisted. Like I said, I thought there might have been an assist, but I really wasn't sure. So we'll go with what the refs gave us there. Here's Gardner with the puck now. Gardner coming in. We're down under 3 minutes left to go in the second period, tied up at two. In fact, just a little bit over 2 minutes left to go in this second period. McDonald plays the puck back into the select zone. It goes all the way around the boards. First one to it will be Lawler. To Gardner. Gardner's shot blocked by Fitt. Fitt tried to play it to the corner. It was not cleared away. And then a dangerous chance for the Stars. Ends up going just wide of the net. Here comes Ailey Glenn. Glenn in across the line. Glenn has the puck knocked off her stick. Getting to it is beaten, but she couldn't do anything with it. Now Gardner coming the other way. Gardner tees it up. That goes wide, as I believe Boyle got her stick just a little bit in the way there. Now Mullins wins a race to the puck in the corner. Mullins trying to come out at the side of the net. Gets poke-checked by Kerr. And now the selects will come the other way with 84 seconds remaining in the period. McLean had a shot go off a leg and into the near side wall. In behind the net. Played to the line and out, as not able to get a stick on it was Grinton. Back into the select zone. Boyle will go back and pick up for the Northern Subway selects. Plays it out to center. Sent back in. Boyle back on it. She'll play it across. Now ahead for McHattie. McHattie gets a stick on it. Hunter will go back and get it for the Stars. Tried to clear the zone. It was knocked down by Emerson McDonald. Now MacArthur plays it across to Jean down into the corner, into the front of the net for MacArthur. They score! A little bit of a you take it, I got it kind of situation. And the selects are able to take advantage with 41.5 seconds left. And Anna MacArthur will get her ninth goal, 12th point of the season. And put the selects back out in front with 41 and a half seconds left to go. Here in the second period, Anna MacArthur, her ninth goal, 12th point of the year. And selects back out in front. The game was tied for just a little over a minute. 19:22, the time of the goal. Or 19:32, sorry, the time of the goal. They're going to call that a good goal. I think they should talk this over. We may see that get taken off as it was played with a high stick. I thought for sure that was a high stick. No goal. There we go. High stick. Yep. Yeah. That is a correct call. That was a very good call there. That was played with a high stick. Yep. I know there might be people out there saying, but Mike, you are the selects play-by-play guy. Shouldn't you be calling it for the selects? To me, it's more important that the integrity of the game is maintained. And from where I was standing, I thought for sure that was a high stick. From up here, it certainly looked like a high stick. I can understand the selects wanting to lobby their case. But, and they wouldn't be doing their job if the coaches of the selects didn't lobby their case. But like I said, from my vantage point up here, It looked to me like it was a high stick. And I realize that might not be a popular opinion among Selects fans, but I got to call it like I see it. It looked to me like the contact was made at or above the shoulder. And so it'll stay 2-1 as we reach the end of the second period. Unofficially, shots on goal favor the Selects in that period. 11-9. Two-period total favors the Selects 18-17. We'll see if that holds or if that gets adjusted slightly. We're going to take a break. We'll come back at you ready for the third period in just a few minutes. It is Selects 2, Stars 1 after 40 minutes of play. You are watching Maritime Major Female Hockey League action here on Petter Sports, is streaming through AO Live from the beautiful Hector Arena in Pictou, Nova Scotia. Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. Selects leading it 2-1. Let's run you through the goal scoring in that second period. Ella Grinton with her second goal, fifth point of the season at 3:48. Opened the scoring for the Northern Subway Selects. Cameron Reardon scored her second goal, fourth point of the season on the power play to tie up the game. And then that came at 16:57. And then just a couple of minutes later, at 19:17 of the second period, Anna MacArthur, her ninth goal, 12th point of the year. Emerson McDonald getting the helper on that one to put the Selects out in front by a score of 2-1 going into the third period. Expect a very, very, very close, very hard-fought third here in this last frame. As we head to the final 20 minutes of action for this one, Selects with the 2-1 lead, looking to finish it off and get their first win of the season against the Down East Auto Parts Stars. Stars won the two meetings in Eastern PEI back in late September. It was the 22nd or 21st and 22nd. I'm just being a little silly here, borrowing a bit from Steve Martin, where he was talking about things with, you know, late afternoon versus mid-afternoon. As we get ready to start this third period, and we are rolling here in the third. Puck down into the Select zone, and again, I am working camera as well as doing play-by-play here, so if the camera works a little shoddy, I apologize in advance. My camera person having a minor issue. Nothing anybody at home needs to be too concerned about, but she had to take off and head home. Wasn't feeling quite 100%, so Lutley with the puck. She'll dump it. Tried to dump it into the Select zone, but that puck gets knocked down. Now McLean sending it the other way, only as far as the line. Larkin fires it down the ice, and that will be an icing call against the Stars. So with 46 seconds gone here in the third period, and the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Eastern zone, and the official shot counter had absolutely no issue with the shot clock as it stood at the end of the second period. So, again, we got to give our guys down in the penalty box huge props for that. They are doing a great job. It's not always easy down there to tell what's a shot and what isn't when you're looking at it from a bit of an awkward angle in the penalty box, but they got all the numbers dead on in that second period, so there you go. Puck played ahead. Gardner gets it up there for Lutley, but Lutley not able to enter the zone on the first try. Gives the puck to Mullins. Mullins will fire a shot right on. Lutley picks up the rebound. Drops it back to Hunter. Hunter, her shot doesn't get all the way through, but there to pick up and get the goal is Candace Player. It's 2-2, 1:17 gone in the third period. A big goal there by Candace Player. Her fourth goal of the season ties the game up. Just a minute 17 into the third. Player with the goal. We'll get you the official word on the assists here in a moment. I thought perhaps Gardner might get an assist, but perhaps not. As we get an icing call against the Selects. Here, we'll get you those assists here in just a moment as soon as Bill gets them announced for us. As the faceoff moving down into the Northern Subway Selects end. 18:26 on the clock, as you can see there. And like I mentioned, we changed our tripod for the clock cam.
Number 12, Taylor Hunter, and number
So it was Player and Lutley who get the assists. It was Player with the goal. It was Hunter and Lutley who get the assists. So Candace Player, her fourth goal, sixth point of the season. Emily Lutley and Taylor Hunter with the assists, tying up the game at 2 at 1:17 of the third period. Here's Reese Murray creating a turnover below the goal line. Couldn't get the puck to the front. Comes back to the line. Held in by Tanner. Her shot goes up into the glass. Stays in play. Puck comes back to the line again. Jean works it back down low. All the way around the boards. Maya McDonald gets to it there. She pokes it back behind the net. Reese Murray can't get there in time. Maya McDonald there. She'll get tied up by Jesse Doyle. And now here comes Baker with the puck. Baker has her stick knocked by Glenn. Baker able to get the puck to Reardon. Reardon now being bothered by... Tanner, sorry. Brain stop work for a moment. Shot from Doyle, steered aside by Kerr. Puck down into the corner, back to the line. Doyle will send it back down low again. Puck comes loose and it'll be picked up there. And out come the selects. It's Hallie Rose McLean trying to split the D. She does! Gets the shot away and it's deflected up into the glass. Stays in play. McLean tries a wraparound. That's cleared aside. And now Gardner's pass. Just a touch ahead of her intended target, McInnes. Played back down into the star zone. Back to get it is Matheson. She'll play it up the wall. Puck gets to the line. Glenn will work it back down low. Doyle going after it in the near corner has McLean on her. McLean trying to get the steal. She does, but she's not able to work herself free. Is coming over to help out was McPhee. Now Matheson gets the puck out to center. Waiting for it there was Grinton. She'll play it to McLean. Sorry. Now in the corner, Matheson tied up there with Emerson McDonald. Coming in to try and help out is MacArthur. Emerson McDonald looked to work her way free. Gets it to the front of the net. And tying up the puck and covering it up is Olivia Lowe. And we get a little bit of pushing and shoving after the whistle. And that's going to not lead to any penalties, I don't think. Cooler heads prevailing quickly enough with 4:26 gone in the third period. Still tied up at 2. The goal that tied it up again, the second of the season the fourth of the season for Candace Player at 1:17, Hunter and Lutley with the assists. Here comes Mullins now, working her way up the ice. Ellie Mullins. Puck is knocked away from her as she gets to the side of the net. And the selects come back the other way. Down deep. There to get it is Larkin. She'll play it up the far wall. Sent back down low. McDonald around to the near side. Up the boards, held in at the line by McIntyre. McIntyre comes to the middle of the ice. She'll play the puck down towards the far corner. Go chasing after it herself. Gets there right around the same time as McDonald. Lutley comes in to pick up the loose puck. Plays it to the near side. Mullins looking to come out. Mullins has it knocked off her stick by Emerson McDonald. And now here comes Kaylee McDonald. She'll get it ahead to Lutley. Lutley with the shot. Kerr steers that one into the corner. Now back around to the near side. Jean going after it there. She'll get it for the selects. Played it behind the net. Now looking to come out with it is Emerson McDonald. That was Maya McDonald. She had trouble getting by Baker. Now the puck comes back to Maya McDonald. Tries to use the wall to get it past Hunter. And with a little bit of help from Reese Murray, they do get the puck into the star zone. Picking up there is Hunter. Her pass ahead intended for Reardon doesn't quite connect. And the selects pick up deep in their own end. Jean gets it ahead to McLean. Hallie Rose McLean. Her pass on the wrong side of Beaton. Hunter got it up going the other way. Now it's picked back up by Glenn. She's got Beaton heading towards the net. Glenn with the shot. The save made. And hanging on for the face-off there is Olivia Lowe with 13:41 left to go here in the third period. Got to mention Ellie Mullins for a second, wearing number 98 for the Eastern Stars. Showing my age a little bit here, but every time I see Ellie Mullins, it reminds me of Neil Broughton. And you might be saying, why, Mike, does Ellie Mullins remind you of Neil Broughton? Well, Neil Broughton, when he was with the Minnesota North Stars ages and ages and ages ago, back when I was just a kid, he wore number 98 because he didn't want to wear 99 because, of course, that was the number that Wayne Gretzky was wearing. But they gave him number 98 because they were trying to show how bright of a star Neil Broughton was going to be for the future of the Minnesota North Stars. And so Broughton was considered as the guy who was just one notch underneath Wayne Gretzky. So they gave him 98. Talk about putting pressure on a kid. His rookie season, he wore 98 for the Minnesota North Stars and got compared to Wayne Gretzky just about every game. He only wore it for the one season, and then he begged the team, let me wear any other number except 98. Because I don't want these comparisons. As there's a shot and a save made. Now, I do not want to say that Ellie Mullins is wearing 98 because she thinks she should be compared to Wayne Gretzky. I'm just saying, seeing a white, green, and yellow with a star on the front and the number 98 brings that memory from the late 80s, or maybe even might have even been early 80s at that point, but from the 80s anyway, back into my brain as the puck is cleared down the length of the ice, out of her net to play it is Kerr. Just one of those little things that comes up from time to time, and when you got a microphone in your hand and you end up starting to spout it out. Puck goes up over the glass now to play. We'll get a stoppage with 12:26 left to go here in the third. All tied up at two goals apiece. And we'll take a minute here real quick to see if we can find out what's going on in the other games here in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League. We have one game that has gone final. The Western Wolves defeating the Fundy Kraken by a score of 3-0. And around they should be at the end of the first period now in Dartmouth, where the Lindsay Surge lead the Greenfoot Capitals 2-0. The Surge sit in fourth place in the league. The Caps sit in second, so not a huge upset, but a minor upset, you could call it, with the Surge out in front 2-0 in the early going of that one against the Greenfoot Caps. There's a shot save made by Lowe, and she's not going to take any chances. She'll cover it up and hang on for a face-off. 11:55 remaining here in the third period. One game still about half an hour away from getting started. The Western Flames and Moncton Rockets. That will be a 6:30 puck drop at the J.K. Irving Center in Moncton. Moncton, of course, where I spent all of last weekend, and I have to give another shout-out to Jeff Robichaud and Mike Sanderson for inviting me to come along for the ride, and another shout-out to the Charlottetown Knights parents in particular, who I got to hang out a little bit during one of their games after I got to call two of their games on the main sheet of ice at the Greenfoot Energy Fourplex in Moncton. Reardon looks to move the puck up the wall. It gets knocked down. Now Vint gives to McLean. Hallie Rose McLean circles at the top of the zone, coming to the middle of the ice again. Brings it all the way to the left wing. Now down into the corner. Hallie Rose McLean still with the puck. Has it knocked off her stick. Gets it back again as she ties up with McDonald. Puck is worked free. It gets to Tanner, who fires a shot. That's blocked by Baker, and Baker will bring it out for the Stars. Baker launches it in onto Kerr. Kerr steers that over to the far wall. Tanner will pick it up, quickly get it ahead to McLean. McLean, her pass a little bit behind her target of Beaton. And now as Lawler tried to play the puck into the zone, it ends up hitting McPhee, who had gone in just a hair early. And so we'll get a stoppage with 10:27 left to go here in the third period. Face-off will be right in front of the Subway Selects bench here on the near side. We mentioned this building 51 years old. It does have a few quirks to it that you don't see in a lot of other buildings these days. One of those quirks, both benches, as you can see on the far side, the Stars bench is pretty much entirely on the one side of center ice, and the Selects bench on the same side of center ice, just on the near side of the neutral zone. So the Stars in the first and third periods have a long change like teams would normally have in the second period of games. So the home ice advantage means you get the short change in two of the three periods, and the visiting team gets the short change where the net is closer to the bench in just the second period. One of those oddities of a building that's built 50 years ago, as opposed to the modern rinks of today, that while the building as a whole may have unique features, the ice itself and the benches and whatnot tend to be pretty cookie cutter. Here's Lawler getting it to the front. There's a chance. Kerr having a little trouble, finally gets it covered up and smothered with 9:42 to go here in the third period. Stars and Selects tied up at two goals apiece. If that result involving the Greenfoot Capitals holds and the Stars get a regulation victory in this game, the Stars would go into the overnight with first place tied with the Selects. The Selects would still have a slight advantage in that they'd have one game in hand. But depending on the outcome, if the Stars win this game in regulation, there's a shot that goes high. If the Stars win this game in regulation and the Capitals end up winning their game, they would move into first place overnight. Of course, more games tomorrow to help change things again, possibly, depending on how everything plays out today and tomorrow here in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League. McHattie gets the puck deep into the zone. First one to it's Matheson. She'll play it around the boards. McIntyre waits for it to get to her. She plays it back down the wall. Now coming away from the boards, MacArthur. Her shot goes off of Lutley's leg into the near corner. Played ahead. McIntyre able to poke it just past McPhee. Now they battle right along the near side wall. Referee yelling at them to move it. It comes free to MacArthur. She'll play it across to the far side for Fit. Fit with the shot. And the save made by Lowe, and she'll hang on for a faceoff. 8:26 left in this third period. 2-2 the score. Stars and Selects. And, Chris, it's only 6:04. You got plenty of time still, bud. Well, maybe not plenty of time, but because you got warm-up to deal with. Chris, got to give a huge shout-out to our good friend Chris, who does all the music with his fantastic company, Nova Sounds. He's got another game at another rink later this evening, so he's watching the clock very closely. And every time we get a stoppage in play, I see him squirm just a little bit more. As the clock becoming a bit of a factor for him. Not a factor for us yet. 8:05 left to go in the third period. And this the exact type of game where you might end up seeing both teams walk away with points, depending on what happens in the next 8 minutes. Puck out to center ice, and whoop, down the ice it goes there. And that's going to be an icing call against the Select, so we'll go all the way back. 7:45 left to go here, third period. Now, I mentioned earlier on that the Selects are going to be in the Atlantic Championships, which will be held at the Pictou County Wellness Center in April. Selects are in as the host team. They'll be joined by the four provincial champions. There's a shot by Larkin. Three of those four provincial champions will be members of this league. Now, if the Selects win the Nova Scotia Championship, whoever they beat in the Nova Scotia final would go in as the Nova Scotia representatives while the Selects are in as the host team. The way the provincial champions are determined in these in the three provinces that cover the Maritime Major Female Hockey League, playoffs are set by their finish in league play. So because there are two teams from Prince Edward Island, the Down East Auto Parts Stars and the Western Wolves, they will play, I believe it's a best of seven, if memory serves, to determine the PEI champ. The team that gets home ice advantage in that series is determined by which team finishes higher in the league standings, which right now would be the Stars. In New Brunswick, there are three teams, the Fundy Kraken, the Moncton Rockets, and the Western Flames. The team that finishes highest in the league standings would get a bye to the final, and the teams that finish second and third play a best-of-three series at the site of the team that finishes second. Whoever wins that series will play a best-of-three at the site of the team that finishes first. In Nova Scotia, it's two rounds of playoffs, as there are four teams. Again, they use the league standings. One plays four, two plays three. Best of five series, winner of the series, go on to the provincial final, which is also a best of five. So right now in Nova Scotia, the Selects would be the number one seed by virtue of being the highest ranked team in the league. Capitals would have home ice in their semifinal against the Surge. The Lynx would be the number four team, and they would play the Selects in that first round series. For Newfoundland Labrador, they play a provincial championship tournament after the regular season wraps up, where all of the teams go to the provincial championship tournament. And the way the Maritime Major Female Hockey League championship is determined is simply by the regular season standings. Whichever team finishes first in the regular season, they are named league champs. And again, like I said, the three provinces each break down into their own provincial playoffs so that we get the three provincial champions and the host. Well, this year, the host also will come out of this league. Last year, the host was one of the Newfoundland teams as the Atlantics were held there. And then, of course, the winner of the Atlantics will go on to play at the SO Cup, which this year, I want to say, is in Quebec. I'll have to double check on that. But the Selects have been the Atlantic champions for the last couple of years, and teams like the Down East Auto Parts Stars looking to dethrone the Selects after several years in a row of being the Atlantic representative at the SO Cup. We're under 5 minutes left to go in this one with the game tied up at two. And we can also tell you that Petter Sports and Streaming through AO Live, very proud to be the production company and the voice of the Atlantic Championships for this year for the U18 female division. AO Live will have all of the Atlantic Championships, and it'll be Petter Sports and Streaming that produces this one. Here's a shot from Mullins and a save made by Kerr. And I am quite proud and quite looking forward to the fact that come April 2nd, it will be myself and some of my crew at the Pictou County Wellness Center just down the road on the outskirts of New Glasgow in Stellarton that will be bringing you all the games from that one in early April. We're also going to have a crew that same weekend It won't be myself personally, but I will have a crew down in Truro for the U16 Maritime Championship after... Actually, that I haven't gotten confirmation of that, but I'm pretty sure that the Thunder got the U16 Maritime Championship. Under 4 minutes left to go now here in this one. Oh, here comes Murray with the shot. Save made. Murray trying to pick up her own rebound, but McDonald there to get on that puck before Murray could get a handle on it. Now here comes McPhee. McPhee working her way down. McPhee gets it across. What a save by Kerr as she's able to come across and get the pad in the way of that one. Just over 3.5 minutes now left to go. Centering pass, backhand shot. That gets blocked. And working her way forward with the puck is Fit. Here comes Fit in across the blue line. Has it knocked off her stick. Over to the near boards. McPhee able to get onto it first for the Stars. Plays it behind the net to Doyle. Doyle coming up the near wall. 3:10 left to go, third period. Puck played around to the far side for McDonald. McDonald. Her pass goes off the skate of Lawler. That allows it to be picked up by Hallie Rose McLean. McLean getting it towards the front of the net. There's Glenn. Her pass intended for Beaton doesn't connect. Now Lutley coming the other way. She has the puck knocked off her stick, and it'll be played out. And here comes Glenn after she stole it off the stick of Player. Down into the near side corner. Coming away with it is Hunter, but she's met immediately by MacArthur. MacArthur battling down low. Glenn able to come away with the puck. Glenn coming up the wall. Gets it to the front of the net. Backhand shot taken by Emerson McDonald. Now coming to the top of the zone, firing a shot is MacArthur. Stepping up from the point, getting to the puck is Grinton. She scored the first goal of this game way back early in the second period. Now it comes back to the line again. Shot from the line by Boyle. Save made. Puck cleared to the corner. Getting on it there is Larkin. Larkin plays it up the wall. Held in at the line by Boyle. Boyle with a shot. That gets blocked by Mullins. Here's Mullins. She'll come out, gain the red line, dump the puck in, and peel off for a change. Under 2 minutes left to go. 2-2 the score. Pass across. Now sent down the ice. McDonald going after it. MacArthur pressuring her. McDonald able to get the puck ahead to Gardner. Gardner carries it in across the line. Waiting for help. The pass for Baker goes off her skate. Baker able to get to it. Turns and fires a shot. It goes wide. Picked up there by Gardner. She plays it back to the line for McDonald. McDonald with a shot. And that's steered aside by Kerr. Doyle steps up from the line. Plays the puck down towards the corner. It takes a bounce out. Selects get on the puck. Can't quite tell the number of who that was. I see now that it was Lexi McIntyre. McIntyre back on it again. She'll play it back behind her own net. Just over a minute left to go. McDonald holds it in at the line. Sending it behind the net. McIntyre gets to it just ahead of Gardner. McIntyre plays it to MacArthur. MacArthur flips it out to center down the ice. Not hard enough for an icing. We're down under a minute left to go. Tie hockey game here between the Stars and the Selects. Inside the Star zone. Doyle able to get away from the pressure of Glenn. Now Player at the far wall. She has to send the puck back behind the net. It'll be picked up there by McDonald. McDonald gets it ahead. Played out by McInnes. Player. Or sorry, that wasn't McInnes. It was Mullins 98, not McInnes 18. My apologies. Now the puck sent back into the Stars end. Back to pick it up, McDonald. She'll play it off the glass. It gets beyond Player. Picking it up is Boyle. Boyle gets it back into the Stars end. 15 seconds left, and it looks like we will have, I'm not going to say it yet because there's still a few seconds left. There's a shot easily stopped by Lowe, and Lowe will cover it up with 3.2 seconds left. And it looks like we are indeed going to have a little bit of extra time just to make Chris's life a little bit more interesting. Craig Clark and the rest of the coaching staff for Selects telling everybody to be ready to head the puck towards the net as quickly as possible off the draw. See if they can get this one finished off in regulation, but they will not as it's taken down to the end boards. And we will have overtime here tonight, or this afternoon, well, today. 6:15 this evening, we'll say, here at the Hector Arena in Pictou. Just one goal in that third period. It was scored by the Stars. Cadence Player at 1:17 of the third period. Player's fourth goal, sixth point of the season. The assists going to Taylor Hunter and Emily Lutley, tying up this game at two apiece. It stayed that way all the way through the end of the third period. And we have extra time. Shots on goal in the third period right now showing as 11-10 in favor of the Stars. Three period total, 28-28. So it's 2-2. Shots are 28-28. One penalty called against each team. Both teams 0-for-1 on the power play. Doesn't get much more even than that. 5 minutes will be put up on the clock after we have this quick two-minute break. We play, I believe it's 3-on-3 for overtime. And if nobody scores in those 5 minutes, then we go to the shootout. You may notice when you look at the Maritime Major Female Hockey League website that there are some games that have ended in ties. Those games were played during a showcase event in, I want to say it was in Halifax. And those games, because of the nature of the showcase and the timing of them, overtime was not played in those games. So those games were able to end in ties. And because every team played the same amount of games, it was okay that all of those games followed one set of rules. As coming in right away, there's a chance for Kerr. While the rest of the regular season played under a slightly different set of rules where ties do not take place. 3-on-3 for now. Another 4 minutes and 32 seconds. Pass ahead to McDonald. Here's McDonald stepping in, shot. And that will get deflected up over the glass and out of play, and we'll get a stoppage with 4:25 left to go in the extra flame. Extra frame, excuse me. Lutley, Hunter, and Mullins out there right now against McIntyre, Beaton, and McHattie. Beaton wins the draw. McIntyre comes in and picks it up. Lexi McIntyre gets the pass ahead to Beaton. That's McHattie. McHattie with a shot. And the save made by Lowe, and she'll hang on for a faceoff. We'll have a stoppage now with 4:12 remaining in the overtime period. Faceoff won by Beaton back to McIntyre. McIntyre sends it down the boards. McHattie going after it, but Mullins gets there first. McHattie able to tie up Mullins. Coming in to help out is Hunter. She has it stolen from her by Beaton. Beaton trying to get through some traffic. Pokes the puck towards the net. And Lowe covers up and hangs on for a faceoff. Both teams will make full three-person changes. It's now Glenn with McLean and Boyle against Baker, Player, and McDonald. Faceoff to the left of Lowe, and right off the faceoff, Glenn tried to get a shot away. She couldn't. Now it's picked up by Baker. Here comes Baker. Baker cutting to the outside against Boyle. Baker takes it down to the goal line, fires a shot, and that goes through the crease and all the way into the near side boards. Following up right on her own play is Baker with it, there's a loose puck, and Player not able to find it, as Kerr does, and Kerr covers up and hangs on as Boyle sets Baker down to make sure that she wasn't able to pick up any loose puck. 3.5 minutes now remaining in the third period, or in the overtime period, excuse me. Face off this time is to the left of Madeline Kerr. Gardner to take the draw against Beaton. That is Beaton. What am I thinking? McDonald plays it around into the corner. McPhee trying to come away from the corner. Puck comes to the front of the net. The only one there is MacArthur. MacArthur looks to play it ahead for Beaton. That's intercepted by McDonald. McDonald getting it over. There's a shot. They score! Emily Gardner with the overtime winner for the Eastern Down East Auto Parts Stars. And for the third time this season, the Stars have beaten the Selects. Second time they've beaten them in overtime. The final score, 3-2. The Down East Auto Parts Stars get their third win of the year against the Selects. They've beaten them twice in overtime now, once in regulation, and they have one more regular season meeting left to go coming up tomorrow at noon. We will have that one for you from right here at the Hector Arena in Pictou. And as the teams shake hands, we will take the opportunity to say to you, on behalf of my camera person, Melody, who, like I said, unfortunately had to step out early, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. A thrilling 3-2 victory for the Eastern Stars here this afternoon and into the evening at the Hector Arena in Pictou. We expect another great one tomorrow. We hope you tune in to join us for it. Until then, thanks so much for watching, everybody, and enjoy the rest of your Saturday evening.